Doris Tiku, 52 years of age, a resident of Inia Village, Adibo Parish, Arafa Sub-County in Yumbe District, could not hide her excitement upon seeing electricity light in her area for the first time. This is after her sub-county and 24 others, including Bidibidi Refugee Settlement in the district, have been connected to electricity by the government with the support from the Norwegian Embassy under the Rural Electrification Program. A total of 304.3 kilometers areas have been connected. Tiko, who is a single mother of seven, said when the connections for the power lines reached her village, she took it as an opportunity and immediately started to plan for a business in order to trap the benefits.
The electricity was connected to Arafa Sub-County. I began planning. I had a plan of acquiring a one refrigerator and begin serving cold drinks in the trading center. And I also want to I also have a plan of buying a small printer and a laptop for photocopying, printing and so on, which will help me to earn some little money for my life.
Anguyo, the LC3 chairperson for Londoga Town Council, said the presence of power will help to reduce the high rates of unemployment and idleness among the youth in the district.
This power, we were vying for it, we knew. This power was going to generate income activities for the communities, just like engaging the youth in metal fabrication, which used not to be there. And that's one of the important economic activities that the youths are going to engage in.
So power moving to Bidibidi, I am very sure it's going to have a long-term life impact on both refugees and the host community members.
According to the Yumbe District Chairman, Abdul Mutalib Asiku, before the connectivity under the Rural Electrification Program, the electricity coverage in the district stood at 10%, with less than 5% homes and institutions having access, as regards to a report of 2017 produced by Uganda Bureau of Statistics. Residents have been urged to consider the connectivity as an opportunity to improve their lives.
In terms of institutions, educational institutions, we have 179 educational institutions, secondary and primary.
My people, electricity is a prerequisite for socioeconomic development. Let us all own the project. She has brought for us this rural electrification that we are launching today. Let us own it. We protect it.
The Minister of Energy and Mineral Development, Ruth Nankabirwa, encouraged the residents to embrace value addition for agriculture products.
I'm encouraging people to do value addition as we mechanize agriculture. We expect domestic cottages that help us do value addition.
Nankabirwa revealed that the target of government is to finalize issues of power in the country, especially Westville, before 2026, in order to drive the citizens into socio-economic transformation.
There is hope. They are glaringly seeing the infrastructure being constructed.
Report compiled by Adam Gule for the news.